Hello everybody, now it is the time to solve some examples to find out that a given sequence is convergent or not. So let us directly start with an example. So the first example is given as xn is equals to 1 divided by 1 into 2 plus 1 divided by 2 into 3 plus 1 divided by 3 into 4, and this way it is last nth term is 1 divided by n into n plus 1. So, in that sequence, for so that the sequence is bounded and monotonically increasing sequence. So, at first what we will do? Our given term xn. So, that xn terms we can write in this way. 1 minus 1 by 2, just look at this one. 1 divided by 1 into 2. If we write this one as 1 minus 1 by 2, just resolve it, then you will find out it is 1 divided by 1 into 2. Similarly, this one we can write 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. Likewise, the nth term we can write 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. Now, if we just open up the bracket, then we will find out this minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 will be cancelled out. Likewise, minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 will be cancelled out. So, finally, we will left with 1 and minus of 1 upon 1 n plus 1. So, we will have this one. After simplification, we will find out n divided by n plus 1. Similarly, instead of n, if we consider n plus 1, then we will find out from here only, instead of n, we substitute n plus 1, then we will find out xn plus 1 is xn plus 1 divided by n plus 2. Now, if we take the subtraction of these two, that means n plus 1th term minus of nth term. So, if we do subtraction this one, then we will find out it is 1 divided by n plus 1 into n plus 2. As n is the positive, so that this entire term is a positive term, this is greater than 0. What does it mean? That we can write, as this one is greater than 0, we can say xn plus 1 is greater than xn. So, if xn plus 1 is greater than xn, that means we can say the given sequence is monotonically increasing sequence, because n plus 1th term is greater than its previous term. So, now xn greater than 0, since we know that xn value is n divided by n plus 1. N is the natural number, positive number. So, n divided by n plus 1 always greater than 0. Also, if we consider n plus 1 is equals to n upon n plus 1, so then this ratio is less than 1, because n definitely less than n plus 1. So, that this ratio is less than 1. So, we will find out that xn, it is greater than 0. And simultaneously, it is less than 1. So that we can say xn lies in between 0 and 1. So we can say the sequence is bounded also. We will find out that the given sequence xn is monotonically increasing and it is bounded also. So that from here we can conclude that the given sequence is convergent sequence. So, again, if we consider the next example, that a sequence is given like this one, xn is equals to 1 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 square in this way, then it is convergent or not, we should verify. So, we will do for the first example that it is monotonically increasing and bounded. Now, we are going with the limit. So, given sequence is this one, and just observe the sequence carefully. This one is a GP sequence with common ratio R is equals to 1 by 3. So, if we apply the formula for the finite GP, then it should be 1 minus 1 by 3 to the power n divided by 1 minus 1 by 3. A, the first term is 1 here. So, if simplify, we will find out it is 3 by 2 minus of 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 to the power n minus 1. Now, if we consider the limit, that is, if we consider limit n tends to infinity for xn, then the limit for this one we should write. And if we just simplify, then as this one is a constant, we can directly write 3 by 2. Now here 1 by 2 we can take out, and the limit only for this one we consider, because here only the n will be involved. Now this one, as we know that the limit n tends to infinity a to the power n is 0, where a is less than 1. Here a is 1 by 3, that's why it is less than 1. So that this value is 0. So that we write down here it is 0. And finally we will find out 3 by 2, which is a finite value. So that we can say the limit n tends to infinity xn is equals to 3 by 2. So as this is a finite unique value, so we can say the given sequence is convergent. So both the process we can apply for to find out the convergency of a sequence. Either we find out that the sequence is a monotone sequence or not. After that, we find out it is bounded or not. If both the criteria will match, then we can say the given sequence is convergent. Otherwise, we directly find out the nth term of the given sequence and take the n tends to infinity for that. That is the xn tends to infinity, xn for n tends to infinity. And if this limit giving us a finite value and a unique finite value, then the given sequence is convergent. Now, should go for the next example. So, this example is here. That example, we will finding out the given sequence is convergent or not. This one we are going to prove with the definition of the limit. So just look, the given xn is this one. So this xn for, we can write xn minus 2 is equals to minus 1 to the power of n. So now if we take the mod value on both sides, then we will find out this one is equals to 2 to the power minus n, because minus 1 to the power n becomes positive while we consider the mod value. Now we say this one is less than epsilon, where this epsilon is a positive number and a very small number. So if this 2 to the power minus n is less than epsilon, then we can write 2 to the power n is greater than 1 upon epsilon. It is just the inequality property. Now if we take log on both sides, then we can write n into log 2 is greater than log of 1 by epsilon. So n is equals to, we can find out log 1 upon epsilon divided by log 2. So n we will find out. So thus, by choosing an integer capital N which is greater than this small n, then we can say that this mod xn minus 2 is less than epsilon for all n greater than n. This is our definition of the limit. So as this definition satisfying for this one, we can say that the limit n tends to infinity xn is equals to 2, which is a finite number. So we can say that the given sequence is convergent and it is converges to the value 2. Now it is one more example here. So one question is this one. If the sequence is root 2, root 2 under root 2, then root 2 under root 2 under root 2. If this type of sequence is there, then prove that this sequence is convergent and it is converges to the value 2. So how to prove that? Here what is given, just observe the sequence carefully. X1 is root 2. X2 is root over of 2 under root over of 2. So that root over of 2, we can say it is X1. So we can write it is root over of 2 into X1. Likewise, X3 for, we can write it is root over of 2 into X2 and so on. Now, if it is xn is the nth term, then we can write xn is equal to root over of 2 into xn minus 1, and xn plus 1 is equals to root over of 2xn. So now if we take the square of these two, then we will find out xn square is equals to 2 into xn minus 1, and here xn plus 1 its whole square is 2 into xn. If we subtract these two equations, then we will find out from here that this n plus 1th term its whole square minus nth term its whole square is equals to 2 into xn minus xn plus 1. This one is the formula a square minus b square. If we just expand the formula, then we will find out this one. So that for we can say if xn is greater than xn minus 1. If this xn is greater than xn minus 1, then this is positive. So for that we should say that xn plus 1 should be greater than xn, because if this one is positive, this one is already positive, so that becomes positive if and only if xn plus 1 is greater than xn. So in the given sequence, if we observe the terms, then we will find out that our xn term or the first term is root 2. That is definitely a positive term. So that we can say, and the second term is root over of 2 root 2. So that one is again the greater than this one. So we can say x2 is greater than x1. So if it is so, then definitely we have to consider that this one, x1 is greater than xn minus 1. So if it is so, we will say that the given sequence is monotonically increasing sequence. Again, if we consider xn plus 1 its whole square is equals to 2 into xn, and xn plus 1 is greater than xn, so that from here it is very obvious that xn square should be less than 2xn. Is it or not? Xn plus 1 is greater than xn, and we will find out its whole square is equals to 2xn. So instead of this one, we can replace it by this one with this less than sign because of this one. Now, if we take this one in the same side and simplify, then we can say xn into xn minus 2 should be less than 0. That will imply that xn should be less than 2. Again, any term of the given sequence is positive. That means that is greater than 0. So we can say xn should lies in between 0 and 2. Thus, the given sequence is bounded also. So we will find out the sequence is monotonically increasing and it is bounded. Hence, the given sequence is convergent. Now, once we get it is convergent, then where it is converging, that we should find out. So where it is converging, for we should find out the limit of xn. If that limiting value is a finite value, and at what value we will find out that particular value is the value where the limit where the sequence converges. So xn is monotonically increasing, bounded and convergent. And now for limit n tends to infinity xn, if we consider it is a finite value L, so that we can say for n plus 1th term also it is L. We know this one. So from here, if we take the limit on both sides, then we will find out that this limiting value, for as we know that this value is L, this value is also L. So if we replace these values by L, then we will find out its limiting value is L. So it is L square minus of 2 into L. Now we take in both into the same side and simplify. We will find out L into L minus 2 is equals to 0. So it will imply that L either 0 or it is 2, but L definitely not be 0, because we will find out that the value 0 never be possible because all the terms are positive. So that we can say xn, that means xn greater than 0. So xn never be equals to 0. So xn definitely be equals to 2, where n tends to infinity. So this is the limiting case, and it is converging, and it is converging to the value 2. Hence the proof. Now it is for your question. So for you, there are two questions I am going to give you. Solve these questions and answer the solution for these questions in the comment box. So the first question is, find the limit of the sequence if it exists for root 2 comma root over of 2 plus root 2 comma root over of 2 plus root 2 plus root 2. It is just like the previous problem, but instead of the multiplication, I am giving here the addition. So just try by yourself. And the next one more question is, evaluate this limit n tends to infinity 1 cube by n to the power 4 plus 2 cube by n to the power 4. In this way it is nth term n cube by n to the power 4. So I am waiting for your answer. I hope you understand. If you not understand, then write down in the comment box that where you have any problem. If I feel to justify these problems, then definitely I will try to do that. So have a nice day. Thank you all.